Hey everybody, thanks for tuning back into the New England Aquarium's website to virtually visit and see what's going on here behind the scenes. One of the things that's really important in terms of skills for someone that works here at the aquarium is to be able to scuba dive. And that's particularly important because we have lots of activities outside of our walls where we need to actually be scuba diving in the ocean to collect animals. But on site, there are several exhibits as well that require access via scuba diving, particularly our giant ocean tank. So I thought that I would take you guys through the process of a diver getting ready to dive in the giant ocean tank. First step is to get my wetsuit on. Follow me. Be right back. Okay, I got my handy New England Aquarium 5mm neoprene wetsuit on. I'm ready to get into the tank. Before we head into the other room to put the gear together, I'll just mention really quick that all diving through the aquarium follows specific guidelines set aside by our dive safety officer and approved by our diving control board as well. Now, in response to the corona pandemic, we've also had to make some adjustments in regards to social distancing among divers, sterilization of gear, and also an effective first responder network as well. Okay, you guys ready? Let's put our gear together here. All right, here we go into the splash room. Come on with me. We call this the splash room. This is sort of the last area the divers access before they get into the tank. They've got full tanks of air here to access. We've got all of our gear that we'll set up in just a second. Showers right behind you as well. It's important to shower before you get into the giant ocean tank to make sure that there's nothing on your body that might get washed into the tank. So let's go through the gear here really quick. I've got myself a pair of fins. That's going to be kind of important for swimming around the tank. I've got myself a mask. Occasionally you'll see divers in the giant ocean tank using a full face mask, but this is just a half face mask, sort of your traditional snorkeling mask there. I've got some weights to put together onto my weight belt. Weight is really important when you're diving underwater to help control buoyancy, which is basically your ability to move up and down in the water, your ability to float. I've got a regulator here that has a gauge on it that's going to tell me how much air remains in my tank. I've got a primary second stage that I'll be using to breathe from. I've got an emergency or octo second stage that I can use as a backup. And then I also have a back plate harness here that I'll be using to dive with to attach to the tank. Now, your average recreational diver uses a BCD or buoyancy control device that actually has pockets inside of it that you can use to inject air or release air. And that also helps you to move up and down in the water. That's generally mandatory for diving in the ocean. Not as important in our giant ocean tank because technically it's not deep enough that I have to worry too much about buoyancy. So instead, I can use this sort of hard metal backplated harness to dive with. Instead. Okay, let's get our gear all together. Do a quick rinse before we hop in. Oh, might have to take this off though. Okay, now if I was feeding the animals or performing other maintenance in the tank, I might have some other equipment with me, and you can kind of see behind me on the wall, we have some of the other devices that our giant ocean tank divers take with them in the tank to help perform those tasks. But I think we're all ready to go. So let's head out onto the platform. Follow me. Thanks for joining me as I get prepared to jump into the giant ocean tank here and join my fellow divers. Hope that was a fun inside look in what dive preparation is all about. Thanks for tuning in. We now have a live camera looking into the giant ocean tank, so make sure to check that out on our website. Thanks again. Keep on swimming.